But in today's prophecy update, a couple things to bring to your attention. Again, there's always issues going on within Israel. Just this last Friday, there was this agreement to restore calm to the Gaza border between Hamas and Israel. So there was this report that came out that points relating to understanding, including stopping the firing of balloons, which they were doing into Israel, creating all kinds of fires to break out in southern Israel. And several thousand Palestinians demonstrated along the Gaza border despite understanding they're trying to restore calm to reach this peace between Israel and Hamas. So there's all these always outbursts of these conflicts that always going on. Some 6,000 Palestinians violently demonstrated, which isn't surprising there, along the border with 21 injured by the IDF troops who used riot dispersion to against the protesters. These battles with Hamas, Hezbollah, and the Palestinians is an ongoing, weekly, daily conflict problem. And it's always interesting as they start the stuff. They're the ones that launch the rockets or the balloons in there. And if Israel defends itself or retaliates in any way, shape, or form, they want a peace agreement. Hey, can you stop? And then they go right back to what they're going to do after a period of time of that peace, right? Funny how this always happens. But it's probably going to be one of the most frustrating situations and conditions to live in Israel, even though it's the safest country in the world. But to deal with what they have to do on a daily, weekly, monthly basis. The world against you, except for a couple countries. And then you always have these imminent threats of war with Hamas, Hezbollah, Palestinians. And then you've got to the other side where you have Syria with Russia and Iran creeping at the borders right there. I mean, it's intense when you think about it. No other country has to deal with what they have to deal with. So you're going to always see these sort of reports. And again, there will be a peace deal eventually that's going to happen. But for that to happen, I'm sure there's going to be some major conflict that's going to go on before we have a peace deal so that everyone's agreeing on it. And that's something I believe the Antichrist will eventually confirm. And this also leads to another article that came up where it talks about how Russia clarifies it will side with Iran against the U.S. and Israel. And this kind of came up in a particular conference in Jerusalem where the National Security Advisor for Russia talked about, again, they don't hold the perspective of Israel and U.S., how Iran is the major threat in the region and within the world. But he said that if Israel strikes in Syria that targeted Iran forces and its proxies, they're going to come in and defend Iran, which confirms exactly what Ezekiel 38 talks about, how both of those two countries are going to be working together. And again, part of this came in because of the situation that happened in the Strait of Hormuz. The U.S., by the way, was doing the right thing. They were flying in international areas. Iran falsely reported that the drone went into Iranian airspace and they shot it down. Now, the world uses the, and lets the, or as the U.S. Has its military fleet there, to help provide a safe passage for the oil that goes to the rest of the world. The U.S. doesn't use that for the oil. The U.S. has its own sufficient oil, but the world wants the U.S. to be protecting that area to get the oil to the different countries. And it's out of the U.S. taxpayers' money. So Trump is trying to, rightly so, try to get the rest of the world to help pay for what they're protecting. But you see the aggression of Iran, the twisted stories that sometimes the media puts out there, that it was the problem with the U.S. there, so they're going to try to retaliate. In this particular thing, it's just the confirmation that you see how Russia is going to back Iran. You know, they flat out said it, you know. On a different major point on war, and this one's more of culture and over to souls, and we've mentioned this many times before, but there's another article that continued to push this agenda. and expose it is the LGBT indoctrination within all the cartoons that are going on out there. You know, there's a heavy agenda with brainwashing, indoctrinating kids' cartoon. So they're growing up with this idea that it's all good, it's all acceptable, and how dare you, you know, say that it's wrong and immoral. You know, so just interesting how many shows now that are carrying on this agenda. It's all put out by the Hollywood elitists as well and the cartoon networks. And but just crazy to see how many cartoons now are pushing this agenda, this indoctrination. So the kids are so used to it. So it doesn't even faze them anymore. And then on a last note here, which is kind of dumbfounding, it shouldn't be, but at the same time it is, how the Presbyterian denomination ordained the first non-binary person as a minister. Are you serious? You know, just what's going on here? But this happens when people move away from the Word of God, when they don't believe that is the inspired and inerrant Word of God from Genesis to Revelation. But here this group of Presbyterians, they're excited about this thing, having this individual as a visible, as a non-binary faith leader, as it already made room for the LGBTQIA+, because they continue to add to their confusion, to see themselves as image bearers of the divine. So it's just sad to see. We should be shocked to see this, but again, in this day and age, it's kind of you know, getting so common. But again, when you don't have the Bible as your source of truth and moral compass, or they take verses and passages, they twist it to suit their ideas, their beliefs, you're going to get more confusion. You're going to get more moral chaos and more problems. And you see this denomination, like quite a few other denominations out there, that are heading towards apostasy. When you move yourself away from the inspired Word of God and you don't teach the Word of God, these things are going to creep up. You know, they have no boundary there. And it's only going to get worse in these last days, these destructive heresies. But if someone denies Jesus as Lord, is a departure from the faith as well. So again, at some point, we'll just unpack what is apostasy, what it is, what it is not, what does it look like. So there's just some discernment there, but there's a lot that can be said. But this is a direction you see of a denomination moving towards that direction. So we need to constantly pray for discernment, for wisdom, and protection, guarding our hearts and minds, how to witness to the lost, how to witness to those in the body of Christ, which are sometimes the hardest people to reach. You know, those call themselves Christian, but they're so far off from the truth. But we need to continue to show love and kindness and grace and truth. And so a word of exhortation for all of us, like we always say, stay in the Word. Keep your eyes on Jesus and to live out your life as close as you can to be to the Lord. And again, the best way to identify a counterfeit is to know the genuine article, to know Jesus, to know the Word of God. And you do that by knowing Jesus and the Word. And that's why we teach from Genesis through Revelation, verse by verse, chapter by chapter, so you get it all. That's it for today's update.